Am I still on? You can hear me? Whoever you are listening.
Yeah. Make sure you get the shoes. We gotta get the
I gotta get the shoes. Yeah.
Quick hand clap.
2, 3, 4.
Are you all rolling? Everybody rolling?
We're all rolling. You do it, brother.
All right.
There's only like 5 photos of me from birth to 18, say. There wasn't a lot of cameras in the family, and then I went camera mad. So that's how it started, really. Getting photos, getting in the photo booth, taking myself, of course, and taking anything else around me. It just sort of progressed. I think I really got more serious about it, more excited and interested in it in the Beatle era. Photography became my passion alongside playing, really. Well, I like to do both. We had a lot of downtime and nowhere to go because we, you know, by then we couldn't get out. So that's why a lot of the pictures are in hotel rooms. But, you know, we'd hang out and we were just lads and we'd play around together, you know? And my playing around was taking a shot. You know, we're in the studio for hours. It was just like, you know, they were singing, I was there, or it was like, hey, take a few shots. And then, of course, George started to play with me. Okay, take this. The most important thing was the playing. The music was the most important when we were locked in that studio. Well, that's arriving in New York. I mean, that was one of the most exciting days of my life. Even before we landed, it was so exciting that we're just so close to America. And the people in the car alongside us were as interesting to me, because they were Americans, as any other shot I was taking. They'd gone to the airport to see us, didn't see us at the airport, and then just pulled alongside us. They couldn't believe it either. Still, I think to this day, musicians come to America. It's like, because it's where it all came from. The blues, the country, and the rock. We're on the train going from New York to Washington, and all the press were with us, and we've got to know a lot of them. But also in one of them, Dezo Hoffman, so took a lot of pictures of the Beatles. It was, seemed a good idea at the time. All those people were shooting us, so I just started shooting back. You know, even when we went on holiday, we would go in twos. Paul and I had several holidays together. George and I had holidays together. John and I, you know, that's how it was. We were very close. We're in Tobago in this shot. Oh, that was the sea urchin. From the beach, he's got a sea urchin in his thing, and this woman was trying to pick it out. There were 2 remedies for sea urchin. It's like disinfectant and you pee on it. Tips. Tips for everybody. Well, this is Paul being in Paris, being very French. With the beret and the cigarette. You know, and when we first went to Paris, we weren't as well known as the second time we went to Paris. And so we could wander around a bit. And John is out there, and the thing about that shot I like, there's no one actually looking at him. You know, he's in with the crowd now. You know, just months later, everyone would be at him. And he didn't have that freedom later on. Actually, we ended up in Japan the first time, and we We all came back with cameras. Because it was the 60s and, you know, different periods were coming about and substances that, you know, the photography went with that, really. You know, they did call it mind expanding, so. It was all, that's all sort of psychedelic, and we were in that moment. A lot of medication in those days. It was the 60s, man. Your attitude changed, your mindset changed. I used to make these huge boxes and heat all the stuff up, oil and water, and project it. So it like ended up as those lava lamps. You know, this is, of course, the fisheye lens, which I still have. I got lucky because it had like a lens you could change the colors on. It gave me that color. It's not like I invented that color. That's what came out. It was all interesting. It was getting more into it as it went on, you know, where you could keep the film stationary in the camera and then shoot again. I think the good thing about the Beatles, though they had taken certain substances, we made the shittiest music. When we say, oh yeah, let's go, man. And then the next day, oh God, it's so bad. So bad. Burn it. So we brought the experience of the music the next day or 2 days later. After the fact was always a better way for me and the other three to record. I don't think I was documenting for later. I was taking pictures for now. This is Mark Bolan. We're just hanging out in London. He was a good friend of mine. Harry Nilsson was my best friend. I was so angry when he died. We had great plans for our later years. No matter what the hassles were, and there were some, as everybody knows, when it came to the song, when it came to the music, everybody gave everything. I'm really, I love that. That if someone counted it in, nobody said, ah, forget it. Everyone, me, George, Paul and John. It makes me cry a little, this shot, you know, because it was a great time. We were Beatles, you know? Oh, that's all right.